Hey there, everyone, and hey there, Barb. Your co-chair sure wishes to be there alongside you today to give one last big thank you to everyone in the room for their generosity this past year. The reality is, we just couldn't have done it without all of you guys. And it makes us so proud to be a part of this community. But Barb, I really wish I could be there in person to say thank you to you. Thank you for all that you do for all of us. Serving alongside you this past year has truly been a blessing for me. One I'll not soon forget. From our 7 a.m. power meetings at Coffee Zone with Ann and Amber, to our Cracker Jack marketing meetings where we took your idea of changing realities and brought it to life, to standing alongside Lakeisha and Elijah and all the agency leaders to tell the story of the United Way and all the great things they're doing for this community, to just sitting down and having lunch with you or having a drink and reflecting on life and our families just a little bit. You know, it's those reflections on our families and life that I'll probably remember the most. As a parting gift, I wanted to give you something that I knew you would cherish for years to come. And quite honestly, Barb, you're just not that easy to buy for. So big surprise, I wanted to do something just a little bit different. Now it's time for us to show you our gratitude and display to you the ripple effect you have had on all of our lives. Because we know you, all of our lives have been changed for the better.
Barb, we think you're amazing. You dressed up like a princess. You rode through town with your dress and your gown. And even though you thought you looked like a teenager in the dress, you were amazing and beautiful.
You are a rock star. We're so proud of you for what you've done for our community, for the United Way, for us, and that we get to say that you're ours.
She's a wonderful asset to the community. She volunteers, as always, with many organizations. But everybody knows if they want to get a hold of Barb, you need to text Chandra. Barb never checks her cell phone. Never, ever, ever.
She has more energy than the Energizer Bunny. I mean, she is after it all the time. And, you know, over the years, United Way has always been able to put together great volunteers to run the campaigns, and you know, Barb has done as good a job as I have ever seen, and including myself, Barb. So you've done a great job. We really appreciate her commitment to the community as well as Chandra's, and we're just fortunate to have them. So good job.
Oh, hello. I've been asked to talk about Barb today, who, as many of you know, we've spent much time together on the campaign trail. Barb, we've had some great memories together, like the time we went to the bladder clinic, or the time we spent together at space camp, or when we took Ann and Todd to the Corn Palace in Mitchell, South Dakota. But we've had a lot of fun times together, and it wouldn't have been as much fun on the campaign trail without you. You know, I have been lucky enough to work with both you and Lori, and you guys have always been kind of mother figures to me, partially because you're old enough to actually be my mothers. But for the most part, you know, you're a kind woman, and you've taught me just so much about what it means to give heartlessly back to the community and really take others', you know, best interests at heart. So thank you for all that you've done for me, and congratulations on 2 wonderful years working with the United Way. So apparently heartlessly does not equal wholeheartedly, as Stephanie and Jane quickly pointed out, and I learned something today. So Barb, thank you for giving wholeheartedly and not heartlessly over the last couple of years.
So I love Barb because she is one of the most kindest, caringest people I've ever met, obviously. That's why I married her. She's always willing to give 110%. If you ask her to do anything, she's going to give it her all, no matter how tired she is. And on top of that, she has the hardest job in the world, being married to me. Probably her proudest moment when she saw me in a tutu. I honestly don't think she thought I would actually go through with it, but because it was for a good cause and she was in charge of it, I was willing to sacrifice my pride for the greater good.
My mom had a hard job. Well, I had the hardest one, not getting home cooked meal. I'm getting dragged all around to all these meetings with her.
What makes me proud of her? Well, I'll tell you a lot of things. She was a great little kid. She and my and her brother, they just got along fabulously all their life, and they still do. And we're very glad of that.
I do love Barbara very much, and she's really a good person, you know. And you don't have to be afraid to talk to her. You don't have to think that you're doing something wrong or she's doing something wrong. And I'm going to cry now because that's how I feel about her.
I want to love my kids the way she loves me.
You know, Barb and I have been friends for so long, and when she told me being campaign co-chair was on her bucket list, I thought she would be awesome. But I did catch her off guard when I actually invited her to become co-chair. She was in Palm Springs, all relaxed, and made that phone call, and I know I caught her off guard, but she said yes. So during the campaign, the 2 years that she's been our chair, I've gotten to know her a lot better. Now I know her as Two Beer Barb, the most interesting Barb in the world. And most recently, during the last campaign, she likes to talk about pacemakers instead of pace setters. But seriously, what I know now, I knew all along. She is inspiring. She's the most giving, selfless person I know. And because I know Barb, my life has been changed for the better. Love you, Barb.
We love you, Barb.
I've heard it said that people come into our lives for a reason, bringing something we must learn, and we are left to those who help us most to grow. Every living, and we help them in return. Well, I don't know if I believe that's true, but I know I'm who I am today because I knew you. As it passes the sun, like a stream that